hiding behind the flag. President Trump replacing an event to honor the Super Bowl champs with what he called a, quote, celebration of America. The president singing along to the national anthem, the U.S. Marine Band, the U.S. Army Corps performing for the president's supporters who were in attendance. Now, the president claims he disinvited the Philadelphia Eagles because they would not stand, quote, for the national anthem, hand on heart, in honor of the great men and women of our military. In other words, they aren't, in his view, patriots. But is that really what this is all about? One heckler at today's event may be on to something. Listen. Stop hiding. He may have a point, because Trump's tantrum about the Philadelphia Eagles and this whole disinviting scenario may have nothing to do with kneeling or the flag or the military. It actually could be all about him, which is why the president may have been at a loss for words when reporters asked questions at his celebration.
Mr. President,
are you saying that the football players are not patriotic, sir? Is that what you're saying?
Will you meet with the athletes and talk to them?
We know the president is happy to take questions when he likes the topic. You know, here he is just last week. Four times, we sped it up so you could see all four times, he returned to the cameras when talking to North Korea to take more questions. But today he did not like the question, so he left. And maybe the reason he did not like the questions, the reason he disinvited a Super Bowl team for the first time in American history, according to ESPN, by the way, was because he thought he would look bad. According to the White House, there were only between 4 and 10 players who were actually going to attend the event. The White House says 81 were promised to attend a week ago. We all know numbers and optics matter to Trump more than substance. And as we all know, this is a man obsessed with crowd sizes and numbers.
I had much bigger crowds than he was drawing.
We had the biggest audience in the history of inaugural speeches. I get the biggest crowds, I get the biggest standing ovations, and I guess you see it in the poll numbers.
The crowds were so big, almost as big as tonight.
If you can't have the biggest crowd, well, maybe he takes his ball and goes home, as he did with the Eagles, and as he has done before. You know, one reason the president canceled that meeting with Kim Jong-un the first time, right, when he canceled it, was reportedly because he was thinking Kim was going to come out and cancel on him. He wanted to do it first. Or take Trump's economic council, which he abruptly disbanded last year. Not because they weren't meeting. It was because they were dropping out in droves, specifically in response to a white nationalist attack in Charlottesville and his response to that. So they started quitting. And then he said, well, you know what? Then I don't want you. And again today, the same thing at the White House. Sarah Sanders was called out for it.
Is the president aware that taking the knee is about police-involved shootings?
The president has made his position crystal clear, and that it's about, I let you rudely interrupt me and your colleague. I'm going to ask that you allow me to finish my answer. I would be happy to answer it if you would stop talking long enough to let me do that. The president has made his position crystal clear on this topic. He feels strongly that standing for our national anthem is something that we should do, something that matters to what makes our country special and unique and what sets us apart. He's not going to waver on that, and he's not going to apologize for it.
Well, he's not going to apologize. In fact, a source close to the White House says far from it. The president is actually going to double down. He's going to pound the NFL on this issue and make it a whole issue in the midterm elections. Pamela Brown is out front at the White House. And Pamela, I mean, is that what this is really about? I mean, you know, you don't have a lot of people going to show up. He thinks he's going to look bad, so forget it. I'm going to disinvite you and say it's about something else. He's trying to score political points.
Well, Aaron, you know, the White House is saying it's really the Philadelphia Eagles trying to score political points, saying that they were engaged in this political stunt. But it appears the president was also playing politics by playing up this issue of the national anthem because he knows that it plays well with his base and it doesn't really carry water because no one from the team actually kneeled or stayed in the locker room during the regular season. So that didn't really add up. And as you pointed out, you know, it's also a way to deflect from the fact that so few of the players were going to show up here because they didn't want to be seen at the White House. In fact, I spoke to one White House official who said that if the numbers hadn't been whittled down from 81 to less than 10, they wouldn't have been disinvited. So clearly it was more about that. And you're right, the president does care about crowd sizes. He brought it up today during the celebration, saying more people than he thought had showed up. We should point out there were Eagles fans here. There were also a number of administration officials here. The view from in the White House, though, Aaron, according to officials I've been speaking with, it was that the Eagles were trying to hoodwink them, embarrass them by trying to change the date of coming while the president was in Singapore, trying by whittling down the numbers at the last minute, that they were basically playing games. And the view within the White House is that if this was really about racial injustice, then they would have come to have a substantive conversation. Mm-hmm. So that is a view from the White House. But what is clear here, Aaron, is that the president used it as an opportunity to revive the campaign issue of the national anthem because he believes it works well with his base. And according to officials, he believes that it will help Republicans ahead as we look forward to the midterm elections. And we're told we can expect to hear more about the national anthem issue from the president as we lead up to the election, Aaron.